In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about slider joint 2D. So in order to understand this, let's look at the example. In this example, I just have a wooden plank. It has a rigid body 2D attached and a box glider 2D. To this component, I'll add a slider joint 2D. Now as soon as I do this, I'll get a green line that one connects to the camera. I'll just run this. You'll see that nothing happens and the wooden log just falls down. But the line always follows it. So these are the properties of the slider joint 2D. The first is the enable collision property. The enable collision property will make sure that if there are other colliders in your scene, then this wooden plank collide with them. If it's not ticked, then it won't collide with those colliders. Like for example, I duplicate this plank, name it plank 2, I bring it a little below, I remove the slider joint 2D first and the rigid body 2D component from it. I save the script, I run this project. You'll see that the wooden plank with the slider joint 2D did not collide with the other wooden plank. But if I enable the enable collision property or tick the enable collision property and then run, you will see that it collides with the other colliders in the scene. Now this connected rigid body property and the auto configure connected we'll look at the end. What this basically does is, if you want to attach this wooden plank to any other game object, you can just drag and drop that game object's rigid body onto this slot. We'll look at this example later. Now we'll look at the anchor and the connected anchor properties. If I zoom in a little bit and check the auto configure connected option, you will see that there are two dots in this. The inner dot is the connected anchor and the outer one is the anchor. The outer ring or the anchor is basically of this game object. It's connected in the local space of this game object. But the connected anchor is in the local space of the connected rigid body. So if you have dragged and dropped any rigid body onto this slot, this connected anchor property would be in the local space of that rigid body. The next property is the auto configure angle property. What this property does is, it will maintain an angle between the two game objects. The two game objects are, one is this game object and the other is the one that this game object is connected to. So it will automatically maintain an angle between those two game objects. But if you want to change the angle between them, you have to deselect this and you have to type in a value here. So right now, this game object is not connected to anything else. It is just attached to a point in space. Or more specifically, both these are same pivot point. Now 0 degrees is to the left, 90 is to the bottom, 180 is to the right, 270 is to the top and 360 is again to the left. Now any value that you specify here except for 0 and 180 degrees, you will see a movement of this wooden plank. For example, currently I set this value to 1. So basically 0 is this side, 90 is this side, so 1 is between 0 and 90. Now let's run this. You will see that the wooden plank is moving to the left. Why this happens? Because the angle you set was tilted. It was 1 degree, that is between 0 and 90 degrees. So it is always under the forces of gravity. So since it is tilted to the left a bit, so it will move in that direction. So in the same way, if you want to move it right, what you need to do is, if 180 is perpendicular, you have to give something less than 180. So I'll give it around 179. And you'll see that the wooden plank moves right. So it's basically a little tilted towards the right. Hence it's moving towards the right. If I give a 90, it will go down. Okay. But it moves a lot faster when it's going down. That's because it's under the influence of gravity. Now, what should I do in order to make it go up? So I'll set it here to around 270. But will it go up? Let's see. No, it doesn't go up. Instead, it chooses to go downwards. Why that happens? Because this game object is a rigid body 2D and it's under the influence of the physics forces. It has a gravity scale of 1. So if you set it at an angle that is either 90 or 270 degrees, it will always consider the gravitational angle. So it will come down. So what should we do in order to make this log go up? We simply need to use motor. In order to use this motor, we have to select this tick box and now we can change these values. Motor speed and maximum motor force. Motor speed is the speed with which this game object moves. I give it here a 10. Let's see. So here you can see that the game object is going upwards. It has a resistance towards the gravity. It's moving in the opposite direction of the gravity, but it's moving a lot faster. So I need to make that movement a little bit smoother or slower. For that, I'll make use of the maximum motor force property. Now, maximum motor force is the property using which it will try to achieve this motor speed. So if the motor speed is 10, it will use 10,000 units in order to achieve this speed. So if I reduce this maximum motor force to say around 10, the speed of the wooden plank slows down, although it's going up, but the speed is very slow. The next property is the translation limits property. Now, in order to use the translation limits, you'll have to tick this use limits property. Let's tick it. What translation limits do is, it basically limits the movement of this game object through this line. It won't let it go to the left a lot or to the right a lot. It will maintain a distance. Now, in order to understand this use limits property, I'll duplicate this plank, Command D. I'll name it to plank 3. I'll remove the slider joint 2D attached to it. I'll bring it to a little left. I'll move this plank to a bit right. I'll make the plank 3's body type to kinematic. I enable a box component. This box component has a rigidbody 2D and a box collider 2D attached to it. Also, I have attached a jump script onto this box game object. This jump script makes this game object jump if I click the space bar, and also it makes this box game object move left or right if I click the left arrow and the right arrow. Now let's try to understand the use limits property. When I tick this use limits property, you will see that the vertical line has become a straight line. It's asking you to specify the limit of this game object. I'll make the lower translation to a -1 and the upper translation to say 1. So right now, I have defined the limits of this game object. This is the maximum distance it can go down, and this is the maximum distance it can go up. Now let's run this project. You'll see the plank going up, but it has stopped at this upper translation point. I'll jump on it. So this is the maximum distance that it will go downwards. And the maximum distance that it will go upwards is this point. I'll increase the maximum motor force on it so that it goes against the gravity. So using the maximum motor force, it's still trying to go up when I jump on it. Of course, it's coming down, but the maximum distance it will go down is this point. And the maximum distance it will go up is this point. I'll decrease this maximum motor force value to say 30. Now I jump on it. You see that that is the lower limit and then the upper limit. So this is how the use limits property work. Translation limits, lower translation and upper translation. The next property is the brake force. Currently the brake force property is set to infinity. That means this slider joint 2D will never break under any type of force. But if I specify a force of say suppose 40, any force of 40 is applied onto it, slider joint will break. I'll disable the use motor and the use limits for a moment. I'll tick the auto configure angle property. Now I run it. So the force applied by the box onto this wooden plank was more than 40. And hence it broke off from the slider joint 2D. Same is the case with brake torque. If it reaches a rotation that exceeds what we have specified here, this wooden plank will snap off from the slider joint. So I'll demonstrate that. I'll make it back to infinity, INF, enter, brake torque to say 40. And what I'll do is, I'll jump on one of its edges. You'll see that it breaks off from the slider joint 2D. So these are the major properties of the slider joint. Now let's look at the connected rigid body property. In order to understand this, I'll duplicate this plank 3, name it plank 4, move it to the right, rotate it to 90 degrees. Now what I'll do is, in the plank's connected rigid body slot, I'll drag and drop this plank 4. I'll untick this auto configure angle property. I'll change it to say suppose 1. Now let's run it. You'll see the plank moving to the left. And I'll change this angle value to 179. So this plank is moving towards this connected game object, but it does not collide with its connected game object. That is because you have to tick the enable collision property. If you tick the enable collision property, this wooden plank will collide with its attached game object. Tick it and run it. You will see it colliding with its connected rigid body. So this was all about the slider joint 2D. I hope you liked this tutorial.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.